Back to school also means back to the gridiron. Join us now for a special football edition of Commander's Corner.
Hello, CFAY. It's Tuesday, the 23rd of August, 2011. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and this is Commander's Corner. We're out here at Berkey Field today because it's just about time for college and high school football season. We got the Kinnick Red Devils behind me practicing. They're getting ready for their first game coming up here on Friday night against Zama. And I'm wearing this different type of cover here today because Woody Hayes used to be in the Navy, and this is the type of cover Woody Hayes wore when he was serving in the Navy years ago. All right, my first thing I want to talk about is energy conservation. We've been doing great. We've been staying not only underneath the 15%, we've been staying well underneath the 25% so far. Let me explain something about the 25% to you. That is a baseline that we have set ourselves, call it more like a tripwire. So if we see we're starting to go over that, we're starting to get not that 25% area, that tells us, that gives us some tips to start doing some things to make sure we don't bust the 15% rule. So far, the worst one we've had is we had 24%, so we're doing good. Now, it's still going to be hot for about the next 5 to 6 weeks, and they're going to monitor us all the way through 30 September. So I still need you to be very vigilant with the energy usage and the energy conservation. The schools are starting back up, so they're going to have ACs on all the time, and we're going to be getting some more folks here before much longer. All right, so please be good with the energy usage, and I think we can do this and we can continue doing a great job for it. This weekend on Saturday is the Negishi Bon Odori, so you can go up to Negishi for the Bon Odori event this time. You can do the little dancing they do. You know, it's something like this and like that, or I'm not sure. I'll practice it when I get up there, and they'll teach me how to do it. Also this weekend on Saturday is the George Washington and the USS Lassen are both having family and friendship day cruises. We're expecting anywhere from 6,000 to 7,000 guests coming on to go out on those cruises. And as a reminder, the 12-hour parking lot down there by the front gate is going to be secured starting on Thursday in order to support those events for the cruises. So keep that in mind. That parking lot will not be open. Obviously, we got schools getting ready to start up. First day of school is the 29th of August. There's going to be some announcements I got here for the schools. Lunch increases. There's going to be full price school lunches will increase by 50 cents this year. Elementary full price will be $2.55. Middle school full price is going to be $2.70. And there's still the reduced lunch price, and that'll remain at 40 cents. New student orientations are happening this week at Sullivan's on the 24th, Yokosuka Middle the 26th, and Kinnick on the 26th also. There'll be sneak peeks at the schools on the 26th, with the exception of Bird. And class lists will start getting posted. You can expect class lists posted for Sullivan's on the 26th, Ikego on the 26th, Bird students are to report to the back playground the first day of school, Kinnick students will get their schedules on the first day of school, they need to report to Benny Decker Theater, and Yokosuka Middle School students will get their schedules on the first day of school, they need to report to the school gym. And for you drivers, there's going to be kids going to school again, so let's be vigilant while you're driving. As I think about that, we did have a traffic accident last night with an injury. It wasn't serious, the accident itself. It was more of a fender bender. The reason the person got hurt in the car was they weren't wearing their safety belt, and they got tossed around with just a little jerk. So always wear your safety belts when you're in a vehicle, whether you're driving or passenger or anything of that nature. This weekend, we got some Captain's Cup events going on. On Saturday, we've got the Ultimate Frisbee Captain's Cup competition. So get your Ultimate Frisbee team out there and get ready to go for it. Remember, Subgroup 7 has swept all categories the last couple of years, and we're trying to look to dethrone them. The mouth that can't be ignored over there, Lauren, keeps reminding me of that. I got you, girl, right here. Somebody's going to take care of you this year, I assure you. Well, maybe I don't assure you, but we'll see what happens. There's a Captain's Cup 5K on the 2nd of September. That's an early morning start. That one will be at 06:30. Get your Labor Day weekend started off by pumping your heart and running a 5K. We've got also for you runners, on the 15th of October, we have got the inaugural half marathon here on the base, the Great Pumpkin Half Marathon. I don't know if Linus will be out in the pumpkin patch looking for the Great Pumpkin during that one or not, but half marathon It'll be ran completely on the base. I haven't seen the course yet, so it'll probably be a couple of loops or so, but half marathon the 15th of October, so try to get ready for that one. We've got a big event coming up on the 7th of September. We've got the 7th Fleet Change of Command. Vice Admiral Van Buskirk is going to be relieved by Vice Admiral Swift. That'll be down at Pier 9 on the Blue Ridge. In preparations for that, that afternoon, you can anticipate a lot of parking in that area being secured and traffic flow changes during the change of command. So be leery of that one. On the 7th of September, that's going to be a big day for the base and a big event for the leadership around here. You might have seen them looking and checking some bags with a little more vigilance since yesterday. Well, that's because we are now at Force Protection Con Bravo. That is a nothing significant has happened to cause that, but you need to keep in mind that this is the 10-year anniversary of 9-1-1 coming up, and thanks to some Navy SEALs, we took out Bin Laden earlier this year. So I think you can anticipate us staying at Force Protection Con Bravo until at least after the 11th of September. So just keep that in mind. That's why you're going to be asked. They're going to be doing some more vigil inspections at the gates and everything, just in order to make sure we're good and safe. Okay. I republished an article in the Seahawk that I had before, just modified it a little for the time of the year, called No Hitting. That's because we had some domestic violent cases, and sure enough, after I printed that article on Friday, we had a couple over the weekend. I just want to remind people that if you start getting mad, you start feeling your blood boil, no shame in walking away. Don't take that extra step and start getting violent and having anything that you might regret occur. That's not what you want to have happen. That's the wrong answer. Now, as you see the pads cracking behind me and you hear the band playing down off to the left, this is a great time of the year when high school football gets going. They're all undefeated right now, so they all got championship aspirations. They played their first scrimmage game last Saturday. I came out and watched some of it. After 4 minutes, Kinnick was leading 20-0, so I didn't stick around much longer. Second play from scrimmage, though, this is a name I think you're going to hear a lot this year, and Dustin Kimbrell. Not only was he going to go, he went all the way. He took his first snap and took it all the way to the end zone. Some more other notable individuals that we expect to see out there on the gridiron this year. Marcus Bowler, he's a wide receiver and a defensive back. He's a senior. Donald Ross, he's an offensive lineman and a defensive lineman. He's also a senior. That name's familiar. I believe he also was back in the spring, you heard a lot about him on the baseball fields. He's an all-around athlete there. Richard Villarreal, Akish Davis, Zach LaCaria. He's my next-door neighbor, so I had to throw his name in there somehow. And Dustin Wilson. So those are just some of the names. Come on out and see the Kinnick team play. I'm sure they're poised for a championship this year. They're going to come out and they're going to be ready and they're going to do good. Now, seeing it is getting ready for the college football season, last year I went out on the limb and I tried to pick the 10 teams that were going to make the BCS Bowl. I went 3 for 10. All right. So this year I'm going to try to improve on that a little bit. And here is my list of the 10 teams that I think are going to make BCS Bowls this year. I'm going to start off with the SEC. I'm going to take two teams from the SEC. I mean, they've won the BCS championship game the last 5 years in a row. One thing to note, though, only one of those years did the team that win the BCS championship even make it to a BCS Bowl the following year. That was Florida. So this year I'm going to go with LSU and I'm going to go with Arkansas to make BCS Bowls, and we'll see what happens. Going to the Big 12 or whatever number of teams they've got now, all the conferences are messed up. The preseason number one is Oklahoma, and it's from that conference. I'm going to go with the Sooners to make a BCS Bowl, but I'm going to take their state counterpart, Oklahoma State, to also make it to a BCS Bowl. So Oklahoma and Oklahoma State. Now on to the Big Ten. Last year I received a lot of criticism for picking two teams from the Big Ten. Those were two of the three teams that I got right, ironically, were the two I picked from the Big Ten. So I'm probably going to get messed over here with my loyalties to my home state, but I'm going to go with the Buckeyes, even though they've gone through a lot of turmoil and their quarterback now got drafted by the Oakland Raiders and their coach got fired. But we'll see if they can work through it. But And then I'm going to take a dark horse. This team isn't even ranked in the top 25, but they don't play Wisconsin. They don't play Ohio State this year. I'm going to pick Northwestern to make a BCS Bowl, and we'll see what happens from there. I mean, I got to throw a couple wild ones out there. Off to the West Coast in the Pac-10, which doesn't have 10 teams anymore either. They got more than that. Oregon made it to the BCS Championship last year. They got a lot of returning talent, but I'm going to go with the Luck. That's Andrew Luck. I'm going to pick Stanford to go to the BCS Bowl out of that conference. Next conference is the ACC. Well, Vice Admiral Vitale's daughters, I think, went to Virginia Tech and are Hokies, so I'm going to pick Virginia Tech there, Admiral, just in order to try to get on your good side before you come visit me. So I'll take Virginia Tech to go to a VCS Bowl. And then there's the Big East, who, depending what poll you look at, doesn't even have a team in the top 25, but I will take West Virginia. It looks like the best team coming out of the Big East to make it. That leaves me one BCS Bowl buster. And of course, everybody's thinking, oh, he's going to pick Boise State. No, he's going to pick TCU. Well, those two play each other on the Smurf turf this year, so one of them's losing for sure. But I'm going to go with a pick I did last year because the quarterback is back and healthy for his sixth year of eligibility, and you're all going to laugh at me, but I'm going to pick Houston to be a BCS Bowl buster this year just because of the quarterback situation. And hey, if you don't like my list and you think you can do a better one, send it to me and we'll see who comes out best at the end of the year. All right, on to your favorite part of the show, the trivia. From my last video, the song. The answer was correct by Richard Anderson. The song was He Stopped Loving Her Today by George Jones. I went back a little ways for that one. It was old, but so am I, so I can do that. Richard Anderson also answered my sports question. It was on the infield fly rule. He got the first part right. You have to have runners on at least first and second or first, second, and third for an infield fly rule to be in effect. But you cannot have an infield fly on a bunted ball. The rule specifically states a line drive or bunted ball cannot be called an infield fly. So that one was false. And the show I was looking for was Speed Racer. The driver was Racer X and his brother was Speed Racer himself in the Mach 5. I used to watch that a lot when I was growing up. And the guy that got the answer for that was William Gray. Now your trivia for today. There was a movie with James Caan and Billy Dee Williams in it where they played actual real-life football players. This was a made-for-TV movie. Who were the football players that those two individuals played in the movie, and what was the name of the movie? That was James Caan and Billy Dee Williams. For the song, here's the lyrics. You give me a title and an artist. I'm burning my candle at both ends. About the only way to keep that fire going is to outrun the wind. All right, so that's that one. Give me the title and an artist that did it. And my one sports question here. As I mentioned earlier, Oklahoma is the preseason number one in the AP poll. Only six teams have been the preseason one in the AP poll and still was the number one when the season was over. That includes post-bowl bowl season. The last team to do it was the 2004 USC Trojans. Who were the other five teams in order to go number one from preseason all the way through the end? Okay. I guess got one other thing to put out here before I wrap it up. I want to put out a, hey, get well to a family friend named Steve. He's been a friend of the family and a really good friend of my sister for years. Over the weekend, he was involved in a serious motorcycle accident. His Harley was totaled. He just came out of surgery a few hours ago. And good luck to you, Steve, and I hope you recover quickly. I know it's going to be several weeks before you're back fully. An SUV and a motorcycle. The motorcycle came up on the short end. His only fallacy is he lives in Ohio and he's a Michigan fan. But otherwise, we want to see Steve get back on his feet in time so he can root for his Wolverines. And we'll see what happens against the Buckeyes again this year. All right. As usual there, CFAY, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great day, CFAY.
All right. right, CFAY, I got some of Kinnick's gridiron finest here. First of all, I'd like to introduce you to Coach Joley. This is his first year coaching the team. He assures me he's going to get us some victories this year, so we're looking forward to it. Remember, their first regular season game is this Friday at Zama, but then the following Friday here, that's the big one, going up against Yokosuka. We don't want the Air Force Wheaties to beat us down here, so we'll be looking for that one. We're going to come out there and do it. I'm going to introduce you to some of the players. Dustin Wilson, what position you play?
Quarterback, sir.
Quarterback. He's got the arm that's going to take us all the way, I bet.
Sir.
All right. Who we got here?
Richard Valerio.
Okay. What position you play?
We're running back and outside linebacker.
Running back and outside linebacker. You go both ways,
yes,
huh?
Sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Looking forward to seeing him carry the ball and sacking some quarterbacks for us, too.
Absolutely.
All right. You get him. Okay. Who we got here?
Dustin.
All right. What position do you play?
Running back and outside linebacker.
Running back and outside linebacker. Boy, Coach, you got a lot of guys going both ways here this year.
A lot of guys.
All right, cool. Same thing. I want to see sacks and quarterbacks.
Sir.
Who we got here? Stannis. What position do you play?
Wide receiver and safety, sir.
Wide receiver and safety. Okay. You're going to catch the ball a lot this year for us, right?
Yes, sir.
Touchdowns and some interceptions. Some pick sixes. Pick sixes. You know what you do when you get to the end zone.
Yes, sir.
It's like a... that Heisman thing, like the guy got pushing it in the years ago. Alright,
I'm Marcus Wheeler.
Okay. What do you play?
I play kicker, wide receiver, DB, safety.
Oh, you're versatile. You're all over the place.
Yes, sir.
You're a field goal kicker?
Yes, sir.
What's your longest?
40?
Oh,
we'll find out.
We're gonna find out and make it longer this year. He's gonna make it longer than 40. Alright, cool, thanks.
Hey. Zachary,
yeah, you're my next door neighbor. I had to shout you out. Who do you play?
Center and defensive end.
Center and defensive end. All right. And again, you're another one that's going to sack some quarterbacks for us, right? All right, you get them. And finally, last but not least, who we got here?
Don Ross.
Don Ross, your name's familiar. You play baseball too, huh?
Yes.
That's what I thought. Okay, what position do you play?
Right guard.
Right guard? You don't go both ways?
Oh, no.
Oh, so you're slacking compared to the rest of these individuals.
Okay.
All right, geez. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you very much.
All right, CFAY, that's just part of the team. Come on out and support your Kinnick Red Devils and get them to the championship. Have a great day.
Ow!